banjo, E, B, G, D, right? Now, I tune it up. There's one dot here that's not true, you know, like guitar player. So I put the dot in there, you know, because they have it in the wrong place on the other banjo guys, you know. So I make sure it's here for us guys. And when a person comes up to me, they'll come up to four good guys that tune in like me to say, hey, Dennis, how you tune your banjo? Like a guitar. Howard, how you tune yours? Like a guitar. Barney, how you tuning? Like a guitar. Tom, I have plectrum tuning. Oh, he's the one I want. Plectrum, same thing. These are plectrum tuning. So that's a hip way of tuning like a guitar. Have your dialogue ready, too. Yeah. So now you got a banjo, you tune it like a guitar. So now I start playing it like a banjo. In other words, don't just go. Get that parada, whatever that's called. That's what I call Dixieland, ragtime, all that stuff. So when you see a part that's just all C chord, the thing that makes you stand out is because instead of playing, play me some stuff. I don't know what we're gonna do. Is the Tennessee you want to play? The thing is, get away from that dude. See what I mean? Now you tune it like a guitar, but then you show off like you really know what the hell you're doing. You follow me? Now these things that I'm talking about, these are good for gigs. I mean, when I'm talking about the banjo, the mandolin, it's not I'm saying, boy, you love banjo, you love mandolin, that's the only instrument you want to play. It's just a guy called you, and he says, do you play mandolin? And say, oh shit, no. Say, oh shit, yes. And then you get a gig. You know, I love guitar playing. I started playing because I love guitar. This is, so I don't have to do the other stuff that I hate. You know, so it means a gig. It has nothing to do with anything. You follow me? Okay, that's one gig. The other is the old-fashioned plantation. You see the Civil War movies. And the guy's always going, he's always trembling. That's the only thing I do. I read the part. That's all. But you know so how good it is? Because the other guy goes, yeah, baby, you're sweet. Yeah. Those are the kind of guys. The new guys always come in and always playing that stuff. And I'm saying, that's why I last. I'll be 80 years old and still be doing some of this garbage. You follow the idea? Put yourself into your real banjo player at that moment. Say, what would a real guy do if he was serious? That's what he'd do. Okay, I'm serious. I'm real. You know? Okay, that's two. Now remember the other one. I showed you what it took me 40 years to learn, right? The guy in Japan still studied. And you got to remember, this is all E, B, G, everything I own is tuned like a guitar. When you're doing that, now you're mimicking a five string. So you hit a lot of D's. G's. A7. A7. I showed it to Joe Pass one day. He said, where'd you get that? I said, Joe, we all studied. Remember when we were kids? Yeah, but I never saw it. I said, yeah, Joe, I used all that. That's refined, okay. So the idea, you know, when you get to all these things, there's only four or five gimmicks, you know what I mean? So you try and get them and try and sound like what you're supposed to sound like. It's no big deal.